In Mastercam 2025, Solid Hole Selection has been revamped and now has more functionality than ever. The biggest improvement is the ability to recognize solid hole features on imported models without the need to run the Find Holes utility. This works with custom hole shapes, segmented holes, and multi-segment holes. New selection filters allow you to quickly filter your selection with fewer mouse clicks. There's also a new hole-making segments page for segment filtering. Let's go see the new changes in Mastercam. Here we have a manifold body, and it has a bunch of holes on it. We went ahead and colored some of the holes depending on the hole shape. We have some purple ones, and yellow ones, and we can zoom in and sort of see that we have some countersunk holes, some just straight blind holes. We have different hole shapes, and some of these custom holes, they're segmented. They're not, complete hole segments. And if we look at the solids tab here on this manifold, we see that it's only a solid body. It doesn't have any of the hole features recognized. So in the past, you'd have to go to the model prep tab and click find holes. And you still might have to do this depending on the hole complexity and depending on the model. But in Mastercam 2025, we really don't need to run that utility for the most part. So let's go ahead and make some drilling tool paths. So the first thing you'll see is in the selection shortcuts tooltip window, it's quite a bit bigger. Why is that? Because we added more selection options. So we still have any of the previous ones with the control click and shift click to quickly filter by the segment type and segment vector. But we added window selection. So this is similar to other softwares where if you left click and drag, you can make a rectangle and it selects everything within that window. So I went ahead and selected the whole part, and we see that it automatically populates the feature tree with all the different holes that it found. And depending on the hole type, it sees simple holes, which is your straight line holes, custom holes, which have multiple segments, like these countersunk holes. It automatically picks up the chamfer, the flat, any of the different diameters that go through it, and it recognizes it as one whole segment. If we scroll over, we can look at the custom holes. It automatically grabs everything from here, even with the split cylinder. And if we go over on a side here, we see that it actually picked up this big radius here. Now, because there's no history with this model, it thinks that this is a segmented hole, but obviously that's not a hole. So we can just left click once and remove it from our selection tree. So oftentimes you're not going to select everything on your part, right? You probably want to target certain hole diameters at a time. So let's go ahead and right click and delete all from our selection here. And take a look at the next new selection filter type, which is window selection with seed. So a seed means you make your initial selection first. So let's grab this countersunk hole. So I'll just click this and we can zoom back out. And now if we window select the entire part, we can see that it found all of the different holes on that part that are similar to your initial selection. So this is really helpful when you have a bunch of scattered holes and there's no easy way to select that. Now, this works with a single or multi bodies as well. So if you have multiple solid bodies, you can window select across everything and it will grab it. Now, because this tooltip now is a lot bigger than it was last year, as you get familiar with the software, you probably don't need the shortcuts as much. So I just want to remind you, you can right click and auto hide and you can hover over it and it brings it back up. So that's nothing new. So before we jump into making a toolpath, let's grab a couple more selections so we can control click and grab some of these purple holes and we'll click and grab that large custom hole and we can green check out. Let's grab a tool. We'll grab this spot drill here. And we'll go to the new hole segments page. Now we can see here that we made our initial selection on that blind hole, the purple hole, on the cylinder wall. So it sees us as an active segment and it colors it in yellow. Now, any segment of that hole that isn't selected is colored in dark orange. So that's inactive. And we have mixed as well, which is shown in light orange. The segment table you can interact with. So you can grab multiple segment types and you can see that it automatically highlights your selection on the right-hand side here. And you can use shortcuts like shift click or control click to grab multiple segments. And under the hole type, we have a drop-down menu of all the different types of holes in our selection. So we can click through and we can see that we can see which segments are active. And this determines the incremental depths in your linking parameters page. So if you only have the top section selected, your incremental depth starts from the top of that hole segment type. And we also have a couple helpful parameters here that show up based on your selection, showing you your major diameter, your hole diameter, the overall length of your selection. So there's a lot of really useful information there to make sure that you have the selection that you want and the depths that you want. So these new solid hole selection changes greatly improve Mastercam's hole making workflow, giving users more control over programming hole features and increasing efficiency.